What you can do with the racket at home. Hi, welcome. This is Suraj from Soul Sports. Today I'm going to show you a few drills what you can do at home. First, we'll start with forehands. For warm-up, you do a regular swing. That is, you take your racket back and then swing. Racket back and then swing. Racket back and then swing. Just make sure you're relaxing your body and then swinging it. Okay, next one would be you take a split step and then step and then swing. A split step, you step and then swing. Okay, a split step, you step and then swing. Next, we'll go to specifics where you will be doing neutral stance shadows, open stance shadows, and closed stance shadows. So, neutral stance shadow is you stay in a ready position, you take your racket back, step, and then swing. Get back. Take a split step, take a racket back, step, and then swing. And then open stance shadow would be, you take a split step, you turn, you don't step here, and then you swing. You take a split step, turn, and then swing. If you want to make it a little more intense, for the first one, that is neutral stance, you can go down, you can lunge. So you take a split step, you lunge, and then swing. With open stance also, you can do the same thing. You do sideway lunges. You take a split step, you do a small lunge and then come up with a swing. Okay, ready position again, a split step, turn, a small lunge and then come back with a swing. And then we do something called a closed stance forehand. Closed stance forehand is when you step across the other leg and then hit it. So basically this is a neutral stance, this is an open stance, and then a closed stance would be when you step across and then swing. So you got it? You take a split step, you step across and then swing. A split step, step across and then swing. A split step, step across and then swing. Just make sure the leg goes across the other leg. Okay, same thing we can do with the backhands. That is a regular shadow to get warmed up. And then you take a split step and then warm up, split step and then swing. And then we go to the next three variations. That is neutral stance, you take a split step, step and then swing. If you want it to be a little more intense, then you go down, you step, you go down and then swing. That is you lunge, step, go down and then swing. Same thing with the open stance, you take a split step and then you go down, keeping the legs parallel to each other, and then swing. A split step and then swing. A split step and then swing. And then we go to the close stance. You take a split step, close stance and then swing. That is you keep your legs like across the other leg. A split step and then swing. Then we go to a recovery. How do you do a recovery in tennis? So after you hit the shot, you have to recover back. So since we don't have so much space, we'll just do with one step, but then on-court situation where you'll have to take 2-3 steps and then again 2-3-4 steps to recover back. But here we don't have space, so we'll just do one stroke and then recover back with a cross step and get back to ready position. So we'll take 2 steps, ready, a split step, 1-2, hit, 1-2, back. Okay, a split step, 1-2, hit, 1-2, back. Let's keep this only open stance, because if you have to do a closed stance and neutral stance, you need to cover more space. So just keep it as open stance. You step, 1-2, hit, 1-2, back. So always make sure you're coming back with a cross step. Split step, 1-2, hit, 1-2, back. Same thing with the backhand. Okay. A split step, 1-2, hit, 1-2, back. 1-2, hit. 1-2, back. Now we'll go to a low ball and a high ball. For a low ball, we'll have to squat down. So you will to make it a little more intense, what we'll do is we'll stay low. Okay, stay low, squat down, and then we'll keep swinging. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and then for the high ball, we can keep something as a target. Probably you can keep a chair and then you swing above it. always make sure the upper body, you're lifting upper body, and my toe, I'm coming up like this when I'm swinging. Okay, and then 2, 3, 4, like that. Same thing with the back end. For a low ball, you stay low and then keep swinging. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For the high ball, you stay up. You make sure you're lifting your heel up, staying on the toe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we'll do a little more dynamic, where you'll be doing a little bit of a jump when you're hitting the shot. First, we'll do with the stepping forward. So basically, it's a neutral stance. When you're taking the ball on the rise, you take a split step. You step, and then you got to hop with the front leg. Okay, a split step. You turn, you hop, and then swing. Take a split step, step, and then swing. And same thing we can do with the open stance. That is, it's a combination stepping. That is, you do open stance, and then when you're hitting the ball, you finish with the neutral stance position. So basically, you take a split step, you do open stance backswing, and then you step and then swing. Open stance, take racket back, step and then swing. Okay, turn, step and then swing. Same thing you can do with the backhand. Split step, step and then hop and then swing. Split step, step, hop and then swing. Same thing with the open stance to neutral stance swing. You take racket back. Okay, we'll start with a split step. A split step, take racket back and then swing. A split step, open stance back swing and then swing. This is to take the ball on the rise, especially when you're doing service returns. Now we'll do speed drills. This will help you to improve your hand speed. So you got to take one position, either neutral stance or open stance, and then start swinging your racket. So you stay like this and then start swinging. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here, make sure you're using the wrist, the dropping of the wrist, and then the contact point should be at your waist height. Don't let the racket go below the waist height, especially when you're connecting the ball. The connection should be above the waist height or at waist height. Same thing with the backhand. You step and then drop your racket, then keep swinging. 2, 3, 4. As hard as possible, as fast as possible, making sure your form is staying right. And then we can do like extreme low to high swing. Okay, a low to high swing, low to high swing. This is to play low balls. Make sure you're getting this flick, kind of windscreen wiper, but not completely here. Make sure you're getting this swing. A lot of wrist will be used in this. Same to the back end. Low to high, low to high. You gotta go back, drop your wrist and lift. That's with the back end. Now falling back, extreme topspin shot, especially when you're playing a deep ball where you'll be falling back and then swinging. So you don't have to take a split step here. You can stand with the neutral stance, put your body weight on the back leg, and then you will fall back and then swing and then twist and put this leg on the other side. So you stay like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same thing with the backhand. You step like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can do that. Then we can do alternate forehand and backhand. So you take a ready position. Just be careful to not to hit the wall because you have a confined space. So you take a split step, turn, forehand, take a split step, turn, backhand, forehand, backhand, forehand, and backhand. You can keep doing this. Now we go to volleys. First we start with a regular shadow just to get warmed up. Make sure your body is relaxed and then you're just tapping the ball right in front of you. And then we got to go with the split step. You take a split step, take a backswing with open stance. When you're doing volley, very important, take a split step, backswing with open stance, and then step and then volley. A split step, step and then volley. Same with the backhand. First we start with a regular, you know, you can either step and do or you can do a open stance, but make sure you're doing it very slowly just to get warmed up. Just to get warmed up, and then you go with the split step and then volley. A split step, turn and then step and volley. A split step, turn and step and volley. Okay, that's with backhand volleys. Then now we can do the combination of both forehand and backhand. You step, forehand volley, get back, step, backhand volley, get back, step, forehand volley, get back, step, backhand volley. So this is a little bit more advanced. And then we can do a low volley, high volley, low volley, high volley. We can do forehands first and then you can do backhands. You step, a low volley, split, high volley. Split step, low volley, split step, high volley. Same thing with the backhand. Split step, low volley, split step, high volley. Split step, low volley, split step, high volley. You can do the combination of low volley on the forehand, high volley on the backhand, low volley on the backhand, high volley on the forehand. So split step, low volley, split step, high volley. Split step, low volley, split step, high volley. So you can do the combination of these two. Now we go to serves. So for serves, toss is the most important thing. So first we'll work on the toss. Make sure you stand in the service position. I hope you all know how to stand in the service position with one leg pointing a little towards front and the other leg pointing to the other side. So first we'll work on the toss. Make sure you hold the ball with your fingers. Don't hold it with your palm. Hold it with your fingers. And then when you release the ball, make sure to not to use your wrist. A lot of them do this mistake of using the wrist to toss the ball. So make sure you use the momentum of the hand to toss the ball. Okay, ready position, and then toss, then make sure it falls right in front of you, in front of your toe. Make sure it falls right in front of your toe. One, like that. Okay, you can hold the ball or you can let it bounce. If you let it bounce, you'll know that you're tossing the ball right in front of you. Serve, shadows. Okay, now go a regular without even moving a leg. You can do a shadow, just see. Just mimic the toss and then swing. And then if you want to go a little more advanced, if you have space, if you are not going to hit your roof, then you can go bend and then jump and then swing. Bend, jump and then swing. If you really don't have space, then you don't have to use the racket. Bend and then jump and then swing. Okay, bend, then jump and then swing. And then you can go with the next variation, that is recovery. So you stand in ready position for the serve, toss the ball, jump, swing, step, and then get back in a split step. Very important, because if you get a good serve and then if you're not ready for the return, then it's no point of getting that good serve. So toss, bend, hit, and then recover back with a split step. Toss, bend, hit, step, and then recover back with a split step. That is serve and recovery. Now we go to smashes. So smash is really important when we are near the net, and then when your opponent tries to lob over you, you get a smash. So when you're doing a smash, it's very similar to serve. When you're doing a serve, the racket goes all the way back, like to get a trophy position, you know? But for smash, you don't have to do all that because you don't have time. So take a shorter backswing. You just lift your hand up and then swing the racket on the ball. So there are two types. I'll show you without the racket. So one is when the ball is in front of you, when you're running from behind, or your opponent gives an easy lob, then you do it very similar to service action. Without just that, you are not taking the backswing like this. So you go like this, jump and hit. And then second one is the actual, the complicated one, where you'll be falling back to smash. So there the footwork is a little different. You got to use the back leg, you got to transfer your body on the back leg, and then you got to jump, and then you're going to hit. So again, the backswing is same. You take it like this, transfer the body on the back leg, and then shift. It's very important to shift the leg. See, I started with this leg in front, but now I ended with this leg behind because I shifted the legs. So you stay like this, okay, and then shift. Stay, transfer the body weight on the back leg, and then shift. That is with a smash. In service, we can also use after recovery, a ground stroke. You can, it can be added. So a serve, and then recover, and then a forehand, and then a backhand. Again, a serve, and then recover, a forehand, and then a back. You can add that also. Hope you've understood all the drills which you can do at home. Thanks for watching. Peace.